Hey guys, welcome to my channel. In this video I'm gonna show you how to replace flywheel in standard pocket bike engine 50cc. In this method you won't need any flywheel pullers or special tools to do it. You just follow my steps and you can do it easy at home yourself. So let's start. First we need to remove the pull start. Just unscrew three bolts which holds the pull start into the engine frame. There are two on the bottom here. And one on the top. Next, we need to remove the coil, so disconnect the wire here, remove the wire from the spark plug, and unscrew these two bolts which holds the coil to the engine. Remove the coil. Next step is to remove the spark plug, and I tell you why. We need to actually unscrew this bolt here, which is really well tightened, and we need to stop the engine from moving to unscrew that bolt. And I know there was many comments before that I'm doing the wrong way, it's gonna damage the cylinder, but believe me, I don't that way tens of times and never happen anything bad to the engine. You can actually take the screwdriver and, for example, place it like that to prevent from moving, so you can unscrew that bolt. But believe me, it will damage this part here, it will damage the flywheel, so, and it won't work, it won't hold this way, it won't hold the engine. So you can follow my way, the way I'm doing. As I said, I done it tens of times and it never damaged the engine and it works well. So to follow my steps, you have to remove the spark plug. Prepare the good quality tool for that bolt here, which is, I think it's number 10. In some bikes it can be number 14 as well. As you see, when I turn, it turns the whole engine. And it's impossible to remove that screw. As I said before, you can try to hold it that way, but it will damage the flywheel, so don't do it like that. What I do recommend, you take the screwdriver, place the screwdriver through the hole here, slowly torn. Till it locks. Now you can see it locks. And now unscrew this bolt here. As you can see, it is moving. Now we can remove the screwdriver, hold the flywheel with the hand and remove the bolts. You need to remove the bolt completely. Here is the bolt. Now, to pull the flywheel out, there are special tools, special pullers. But as I said, we will do it without one. So that's why we have removed the coil to have access from this side between the engine frame and between the flywheel. So now take the flat screwdriver, place it here and pull, turn, pull, turn, pull, and you can see it pops up. So that's simple, like it is. You don't need any special pullers for the flywheel. You can easily do it with the screwdriver. The only thing is you need to remove the coil to have access from this side here. So now when you there's few reasons you can actually replace the pull start, the flywheel. One of the reason is that you have replaced the pull start, and there's few different flywheels to fit few different pull starts. This flywheel with these two metal pins, the springs, it is for easy pull start. In my opinion, is the best pull start you can find on the market. It makes starting the bike very easy, and it's also very reliable. They don't break like that often as standard ones. So if you replace, for example, pull start for better version, you may need to replace the flywheel as well. The other reason could be that the flywheel have broken and is shaking, so you just replace the flywheel. So now I'll show you, say this is a new flywheel, how to install the new flywheel on the engine. So first thing you have to, when you're removing the old flywheel, you have to be careful. Here it's a metal pin. I hope you can see clearly. And you need to make sure the pin is in position when you're placing the new flywheel. And the pin has to go into that place here. So you need to fit that properly. You can see it from this side that the pin is in position, so the flywheel is properly installed. Now when you've done that, you can actually take the hammer and punch a little bit on the side to make sure it fits. Fit well in position. Next is to install the bolt. I highly recommend that you put the tread lock on the tread. So here is the tread lock. We put the tread lock on the tread and then install the bolt. Make sure you use good quality tools. tied the bolt very well. Now we have installed the new flywheel. Now we will install back again the coil. To install the coil, simply find the space on the flywheel with the magnets. That's the space with the magnets. Take the tape. Place the tape on the to cover the magnets. Put the two layers of it. Turn the flywheel that direction so the magnets are here. And now just simply put the, you can see it actually holds, the magnets holds the coil. So place that, make sure it holds. Now use the thread lock again on the two bolts which holds the coil and install the bolts. Tie the bolts well, but do not over tight. Make this is aluminium, so do not over tight. Do it with feelings. Now turn the flywheel and remove the tape. And this tape actually gave you the proper space between the coil and the flywheel. That's the easiest way to properly install the coil on the engine. Now we have to install the spark plug. Put the cable on the spark plug. Connect the black cable back to the wiring and install the pull start. Insert all three bolts and tie them in. And you have just installed new flywheel on your engine. Thanks for watching. If you like my videos, please subscribe to my channel. There is much more videos coming in. And thanks for watching. See you guys. Bye.